Let me just announce that Cosmos Dukemeka has joined us now.
Yeah.
Cosmos, we're happy to have you on Sports Tonight.
It's my pleasure.
Yeah, all right. And Yemi Adebayo is still very much with us on the show. It's time for us to talk domestic football now, and this time, domestic football, not in the boardroom, this time, domestic football on the pitch. And it doesn't come bigger than March Day 7 of the Nigeria Professional Football League. We're going to be having 6 games across different centers in Nigeria, and that's because 4 of our clubs will be missing in action. They will be busy on with preparations to play on the continent. But let's quickly run through the fixtures first of all. Tomorrow we'll be having 5 out of the 6 games. There will be one on Thursday. But let me just run through for you the fixtures for tomorrow. Abia Warriors. Okay, all right. Okay, Enugu will be playing Akwa United. For once, I was wondering if that was wrong because Enugu are used to playing on the continent. Mm-hmm. But they're not going to be on the continent this season. They are playing Abia Akwa United tomorrow in Calabar. That's when that game will be played. League leaders unbeaten. The only club unbeaten this season. Plateau United will be hosting El Kanemi Warriors in Jos. Abia Warriors will be hosting Sunshine Stars in Umahia. Gombe United will be hosting Nasarawa United at the Pantani Stadium in Gombe. And then in Shagamu, at the Gateway Stadium in Shagamu. Is that what they call it? The Gateway Stadium in Shagamu?
Yeah.
It will be Remo against Tornadoes of Minna. The games, Rivers United against Pillars, Rangers against Lobi, Wiki Tourist against Shooting Stars, and the ABS against MFM, Katsina United against, I beg your pardon, Katsina United against Ifeanyi Oba are all on hold because the teams are going to be on the continent. And then on Thursday, ABS will be hosting the high-riding MFM in Ilorin. Those are the fixtures of March Day 7 on the domestic scene, the Nigeria Professional Football League. All right. Our friends who spend a lot of their resources and time to propagate the gospel of domestic league in Nigeria, the league bloggers, have a tradition of honoring the best coach and the best player every month. And they've come up with the nominations for January. And the coaches are shortlisted for the awards in January. Kennedy Boboye, coach of Plateau United unbeaten this season. Fidelis Ilechukwu of MFM High Riding, doing so well. Henry Makinwa as well, coach of ABS, and then Gbenga Ogunbote, I beg your pardon, of Enyimba. These are the nominees for January, for managers, for players. Stephen Ode, young lad, top scorer with 5 goals so far for MFM. Kabiru Omar has been a revelation for Plateau United, is a hold wars. Sikur Olatunbosun is the second MFM player in that shortlist. He's also been amazing, providing a lot of assists for Ode and scoring a lot of goals as well. And then goalkeeper Femi Thomas of Rivers United also makes the shortlist for the players for the month of January. All right, so these are the nominations from our friend League Bloggers MPFL Monthly Awards. Oh, okay, so let's talk very quickly, guys. Cosmos, Nigerian clubs on the continent, you were talking about that earlier on.
Yeah.
We need to do a lot more.
Yes, certainly.
When you look at the log. But we must, first of all, commend the fact that we've played 6 weeks before their first game on the continent. Unlike in the past when it was a gamble. You go blindly. Not knowing your strength or your weaknesses or what you need to work on. You go blindly and most times you are turned back.
Mm.
This time, we should be able to get things right.
Yeah, that is the hope. That is our expectation. That you know, somehow it's going to be easy peasy for the teams in the continent, Nigerian teams in the continent, but then you just have to realize that it's a different ball game. I mean, you look at these teams, these 4 teams, I mean, Rivers and Rangers International are pretty much not in the best of form and all that, so we just hope that things improve for them in the continent. Of course, Rivers United are pretty much doing fine and they're doing well too, although they are very tough opposition as well. Ifeanyi Oba, yes, are getting themselves back in the groove and all that, but the question is, would they be able to replicate you know, some bits of their home form away, especially when they are playing in the continent. And of course, wicket tourists, that a lot of things probably don't know when it comes to the continent. Can wicket tourists be able to, you know, represent us well and all that?
How confident are you that these teams will do well? Which of these teams are you so optimistic about their chances of doing well? When you look at what Mamelodi Sundowns did last season, you ask yourself, is it difficult for a Nigerian club to be able to replicate this?
Well, optimism sometimes is
okay. Today, sorry to cut you, okay. That's the governor of Enugu State met with the players of Rangers. They paid him a visit and he charged them to go out as they prepare to leave for their continental engagement this Saturday. Told them to go out there and defend the colors of the club, defend the state, and go do Nigeria proud. I think it's good.
I think really it's good. I mean, the last time that we had a pretty much total support for a team playing in the continent was way back in 2003 when Emojo Zokalo was the governor of Abia State at the time. He gave them total support, not just moral support. It was total support, and you could see that they won the Champions League back to back at that point. And it shows that the support is there. The fact that he understands that the success of Rangers International in CAF in Africa is not going to be for Nigeria. It's going to come down, and it will be that okay, during his time, Rangers did this, Rangers did that. Like everybody are talking about Oju Zokalo when it comes to the support of Eyimba. So I think it's a very good one, and it's a good thing that the Nigeria Football Federation, according to their communique today, are also lending some sort of support. They understand too that Nigeria needs to do well so that the kind of numbers of teams, the coefficients and all that they have in CAF will continue and probably increase. So I think it's a good one. You were asking me the other time about optimism. I feel I'm optimistic. I mean, you talked about Mamelodi Sundowns. I mean, at the beginning of last season, they didn't even win the league. They just managed to qualify for the Champions League. And a lot of people didn't give them that much chance. But then they went and they made sure that they changed everything about them. And okay, today they are champions.
You mean, can Rangers... but it's too early to begin to talk about winning now.
Yeah.
What do you see for the teams, our four teams on the continent? Rangers, Rivers, Ifeanyi Uba, Wiki Tories. What do you see?
All our teams will not crash out in the first round.
That's very key.
That's very key.
And it starts this weekend.
That I'm very sure. Especially because they've had a few. They're not going in this blindly, like you said. They're not, you know, playing football matches is a true test. If you train, no matter what you do in training, it doesn't really tell you much, you know, but if it comes off well in a game, that's when you know if what you have done in training actually worked. I see our teams doing better than... I'm a bit more confident with the teams in the Champions League. I don't know why. I'm a bit confident with Rangers and Rivers, and I have a feeling that they're going to do well. And when you see pictures like this, you know, coming out, the governor
showing support,
you know,
from the state
taking
government,
pictures with the players, showing, you know, that solidarity, it makes you feel that all of those off-field distractions will not come into it, and the players will be able. And if, I mean, you just need to remind yourself, for Rangers or Rivers United, for example, just go back and look at the clips, their matches of last season. Then you want to tell yourself, if they can play the way they played,
particularly Rangers,
you know, go away and make life difficult for an home team. If they can't do that in Nigeria, they should be able to do that
On
the continent. Go away and just believe that everybody's against you. And if everybody's against you, you have nothing to lose. I mean, they're all going to come at you. So you know that you have only yourself, you know, and your comrades on the pitch, and you just go for it and play your game. So I think it's not going to be tales of doom this time. I think the first round will not be the exit point for our teams, but I'm afraid that inexperience might cost us in a confederation cup. That's just my opinion.
Anyway. Let me read a few comments on Twitter very quickly. Ayola Tokwe says, talking about the league, he says, up MFM FC, He's talking about the sweet brand of football that they're playing. He says they will play in the CAF Champions League next season. It's just match day six. There's still a lot of time.
Should have learned from last season.
But then anything can happen. So we just keep our fingers crossed. But we must commend MFM for what they've been doing, really. They've improved on their brand of football from last season. And you can see that the results.
And they have made fans rechristen Agege Stadium the Soccer Temple.
Yeah, people call it the Soccer Temple.
Because of the way they
because
play.
Of the way they play, you know. So that's very encouraging. But let's see how it goes. And Ayolatope says he's saluting Cosmos as well. Maybe it's a friend of Cosmos, or a fan, a big fan of Cosmos, Chukwuemeka. Joe Ejiofor, at Joe Ejiofor, says if big names win trophies, Abraham Grant would have won AFCON for Ghana. He says what Ghana needs is a coach who understands African football. That's what they need. But well,
if they're going to get a local coach, give him respect, and that's what the Ghanaians have done.
But the problem is, when was the last time? When was the last time Ghana even had a local coach? I mean, the one they had was the first one in about 20 years. I mean, look at it 20. From 1992 to.
No, three years ago, when they had that coach, what was the last time they had a black coach? They've had a lot of local coaches.
In the 90s?
They've had Cecil Jones at Okefio, who was passed on.
They've had
some local coaches.
In the 90s?
But the challenge is, and of course, Kwesi Appiah. I told you about Cecil Jones at Okefio. They've had a fair share of local coaches. But the problem usually is, Yemi said it. When you have a local coach,
they don't respect them.
That's the problem we have. It's a big problem in Africa. The respect that
I remember an incident with Kwesi Appiah. Something happened with the Ayew brothers, and you know, probably put one of them or something.
That was 2013 Nations Cup.
And they decided to just, you know, the FA forced him to call those guys back.
Yeah.
There was an incident like that. A coach takes a decision, and the players are powerful. And, you know, but they don't do that to foreign coaches. I think it's everywhere.
But you know, another issue is this. You need to have the luck to get the right kind of foreign coach. Somebody who is ready to work, to settle down, to struggle with you, cope with whatever challenges you have, understand your situation, and do the job.
In this scenario that you just painted, if there's any country that I envy, a lot of people will say the results do not justify what I'm saying. South Africa. They give a coach a task. They are patient. They set out the ground rules. They tell the coach what that's. And whenever they decide to fire a coach, the last time they fired Sheikhs or put him aside, whichever one, nobody had anything to say. Yeah. Even though he looked flimsy.
When
they sacked Kisso Mosimane, nobody had anything to say. They gave him the opportunity. They gave him the respect. Do whatever.
So that's
and when the results don't line up, you go.
So the thing is, when you go for a foreign coach, you have to be lucky to get the right one.
To get the right one that will understand, live, and enjoy Africa.
When you want to get the local one,
just give him the free hand to be able to operate.
I think Ghana should go back to what is his name? This French man. It's actually their former coach. They should go back to him. Probably will bring everything back to them. The coach that took them to Ghana 2008.
Claude
Leroy.
That was in Togo, the last Nations Cup.
We
are not here to choose for Ghana. You can consult the Cosmos privately later on. Maybe we can recommend for you.